This afternoon, about 1:25 p.m, as arranged, I turned up at Geraldton Police Station to see a detective from the detectives in Geraldton. I didn't get to see one. I saw a sergeant called Ashworth Priest. His name is A-S-H-W-O-R-T-H, Priest, P-R-I-E-S-T. His regimental number is 8472. Ashworth Priest seems to stand for, I wouldn't have a clue in hell what I'm talking about. Well, it certainly fits him doing that, because apparently the council can sign a piece of paper, even though they're a registered company, HCA 11 of 2015, the High Court ruled, doesn't matter if you're a government entity, if you have an ABN number and you provide services for money, you're a trading company. We had the registration of the City of Greater Geraldton. It is a trading company, it has an ABN, allegedly provides services for money, which it doesn't do. It just says it does, but it doesn't. And this Ashworth Priest, who knows everything and doesn't seem to know anything at all, he's supposed to be a sergeant. He would have been there in the police force since 1977-78, around then, pretty close. So he would have sworn the lawful oath of allegiance. But look at that, he's breached it. He's breached the oath of allegiance because he's not upholding the crown. Your land is alienated from the crown in peace simple. Whose job is it to arrest thieves? His. But he don't want to do it. So rather than do his job, he lied. He lied to me, he lied to my wife, because he said, this is a civil matter. And I said, but they stole my land. No, 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 no. You've got to take it to court. You've got to do this. I said, no, they have to take it to court and prove I owe them money. They didn't. When they did take it to court, the court wouldn't rule. When they went to court last year, I challenged their ability to seize the property, given that the Local Government Act hadn't been complied with. I also seized my property under Clause 61, a lawful law that Ashworth Priest swore his oath to uphold, which is Magna Carta. When did the people have a referendum to remove Magna Carta? We didn't, because we can't. Your oath of allegiance is to the coronation oath of the Queen, which is Magna Carta, Habeas Corpus, 1688, Bill of Rights, Act of Settlement, Halsbury's Laws of England, Chalice Real Property. Sorry, Ashworth Priest, you're a traitor. You also are a liar. You lied to protect the Shire. You said it was a civil matter. It is not. It is outright stealing. You know what that means? It means if you take something off somebody by lying, cheating, or doing anything else without that person's permission, that's stealing. Have you finally got, after all these years that you've been in the police force, can you now comprehend they stole my land? There was no court order to say they couldn't touch it. There was no court order to say they could touch it, because a magistrate, the first time in 2011, wouldn't rule either way, which means they didn't get a decision. So their application was dismissed. Their application was for me to pay $46,000. Where'd the $100,000 of court costs and interest for those court costs come from when nothing was proved? The case is before the High Court. It was before the Supreme Court. And it's called High Treason and Fraud in the Supreme Court. And you see the two clowns that call themselves judges, which are only quorums, they wouldn't make a decision. They refused to. They refused to abide by the Constitution. That's treason. And you, Ashworth Priest, you're refusing to abide by the Constitution. That's treason. Section 83 of the Commonwealth Criminal Code. You breach the oath of allegiance you owe to the people. That's treason. Now you know, as I told you, you're concealing it. So you're guilty of misprisoner treason. Look at that. Look at all the years in jail you're going to do, Ashworth Priest. All because you are too stupid to understand. You swore an oath of allegiance to complete a job. That job was uphold the rights of the people under the Constitution. Your state laws, state acts, state statutes, rules, regulations and everything else only continue after Federation, subject to the Commonwealth Constitution. If that wasn't the case, why did the government ask us in 1974 to approve local government? Why did they do it again in 1988? Why did they do it in 1999 when they tried to get a republic? Why did they do that? Because they realised at the Constitutional Convention in 1988 that they were breaking all the laws. They hadn't been lawful for a lot of years. It's in their documents. And look in 1979. Good old Bill Shorten's putting up there, Labor's going to do this, Labor's going to do that. Labor's not going to do anything except take everything you've got, which is what the Local Government Act is. Takes your land. You have every right of ownership, except you don't own it, it's under the Crown. Well, the documents I've got show that, look at that, under the Magistrate Court Act, if the Council seizes your land, it's alienated from the Crown in fee simple. How is it alienated from the Crown in fee simple when ours is in fee simple and it's not alienated from the Crown? How does that work? Oh, Ashworth Priest, you didn't even want to find out. When I showed you decisions of the High Court, says my land is in fee simple, it's only your opinion. I said, no, it's a decision of the High Court and you're bound by that. Oh, no, it's still only your opinion. Are you void of all understanding or are you just too stupid? Maybe you should give up a few lamb chops and pork chops. You're getting a bit fat there, mate. It's growing in your head. You're failing to understand the laws there. Oh, you must have that much garbage in your head. You can't see round the pig fat. Isn't that nice? You ignorant, arrogant, silly little old man. You couldn't see that you're committing treason. You couldn't see that you were lying to me. You couldn't see that you were biased against me. You couldn't see that you had no intention of doing your job. You were just upholding the government's lying, thieving method of taking our property off us. For that, Ashworth Priest, number 8472, Sergeant, you're going to pay for that. You're going to go to jail for a long, long time. And you'll have to explain to your family why you're a traitor, why you're a thief, because you're party to the stealing of the land now. 146 to 149 of the Commonwealth Criminal Code says you are. You're a thief. You're a liar. You're a fraud. And you're a traitor. Have fun living with that. I hope all your family see you for who you are. I wish, because I was in that job for a long, long time, I had a lot of respect for it. For you, I have none. None because you're not worthy of any respect. You've given up your right to respect when you gave up your oath of allegiance, and that's to the people. And you are really employed under an imperial act under the Statute of Monopolies. And if you look at HCA 44 of 2010, Chief Justice French said all that is alive and well. So you've breached that again. Another act of treason. You have fun, Ashworth Priest, 8472. You're going to have a good little life just waiting for the knock on the door. When someone in a uniform comes along and carts you away. Hopefully it's not to the funny farm, just to a jail cell for your act of treason and fraud. Have a nice day, Ashworth Priest 8472. Just have a nice day.